Hey guys, in today's video, I'll be talking about sales funnels and their benefits for your business. Be sure that you stay tuned. Hey guys, Bashar Ketu here, Amazon FBA seller from beautiful San Diego. Welcome to my channel. In my channel, I do talk about Amazon FBA and other relatable topics, typically ways to making money online. Now, in today's video, specifically, I'll be talking about sales funnels and how they can benefit your business. You know, about a year ago, I was actually introduced to a software called ClickFunnels and mainly to its founder, Russell Brunson. And really, I started following the man because I started seeing him, honestly, in many Facebook ads. And really, just a few short months after, I actually attended to one of his webinars. And after that, I was, you know, started soaking a lot of the information that I got from that webinar. I even got a CD over to my, you know, delivered to my home, which I watched. And that helped my business tremendously, which is selling products on Amazon. I personally use sales funnels to selling products on Amazon. I create Facebook and Instagram ads and bring in traffic from those platforms onto my Amazon store. So not only do I rely on Amazon traffic alone, I must say my journey with sales funnels started very rough. You know, the early on funnels that I created were very bad. In fact, they didn't even turn any, you know, they didn't convert any sales. They were just, you know, a bunch of wasted money via clicks that people came through, you know, my Instagram and my Facebook ads. However, just shortly after, I was able to reverse engineer similar funnels and similar sellers doing simply the same exact thing. And all I did was copy their funnels and put on my personal twist to it. And that is how I was able to accomplish success. So let's talk about what sales funnels are. Sales funnels are simply a way for your prospective customer to be taken from one step to another following a simplified and a very unique method of explanation and actually sales, but without really making it feel like it's an actual sale. And it's transitioning your customers from one page to another without them really feeling, you know, that you're actually really pushing a sale out to them. I am almost 100% sure that almost all of you guys have gone through some sort of a funnel, you know, in the past couple of weeks, couple of months, maybe even a couple of years. Maybe it was a commercial for some type of a supplement online, or maybe some type of, a product, you know, like this camera that you guys are seeing me through right now. It's a GoPro that I purchased online, actually. And it's sitting on a stand that's got a halo light that I actually saw on Instagram. It was an ad. I clicked on it. It took me to a landing page. And that's typically what you get or what you take your customers onto first, because really the whole point of all this is getting their email addresses. That way you can retarget them with either emails or ads or both. And that's exactly what I do in my business. So first you would want to run an ad for whatever product or service you are providing. And then from there, once they click on that ad, then they go onto what is called a landing page. Typically, you want to keep your landing pages very simple, very clean, very to the point. Asking them to insert their email address and name in exchange for something for free. So let's say you would be offering them, you know, let's say if you are selling a Christmas present or something like that, you would be offering them a simple product for free if they were to give you their email address. And I'm pretty sure many of you guys have gone through some guru's, landing page or sales funnel where you were promised to have a downloadable ebook. And that's kind of their way of giving you something in exchange for your email. So once you put in your email, now they have it. Now they can retarget you with Facebook ads, Instagram ads, you know, other Google placements, and also most importantly, emails. And that's exactly what you also would do for your business or product. And then from there, you take them onto a sales page where you give them a pitch. Let's say if you are selling a, like when I saw this this light here, it was a demo pretty much, a video that took me through, how this product is used, you know. And from there, you take them to not a sales page, but a checkout page where they actually make the option to purchase. Now, only that happens if they actually like the product or the service and they actually really want to buy that product. And then typically after that, after they even have purchased, you would want to take them to what is called either an upsell or a downsell page. Typically what, you know, why they go to an upsell or downsell page, let's say they go to an upsell page if they actually had purchased the initial offer. So let's say when I bought this light, I was upsold to another accessory, you know, which I also happened to buy, you know, it was like a selfie stick kind of, you know, for the camera, which I also bought. However, if I had declined to buying the main product, which is the light itself, I would have then gone to a downsell page. Typically, it's either a cheaper product or a cheaper way to pay for the product. Let's say if you are a guru selling a service or a course, maybe you would offer a payment plan, you know, or a discounted product for a discounted price for something, not as much, you know, maybe you're selling a course. And instead of offering it with mentorship or whatnot and other services, maybe you would offer just the course by itself or just something else that's simplified that you can offer for a cheaper price. After that happens, you would want to take your customers to a thank you or a confirmation page, which is where, you know, you pretty much summarize their order if they did purchase, and if they didn't, just a thank you page. Many times I have seen also some sales funnels that take customers to a page where they actually give them links to other services that they are affiliates for. So similar services, let's say, if I did not buy the slide or if I even bought the slide on the confirmation/thank you page, there also would be some links to similar products, like maybe some cameras or maybe some mics, like portable USB mics, or, you know, whatever else that a photographer or a YouTuber or someone would be interested in this light would also be interested in, you know. So typically that is your thank you page, or it could be just simply your confirmation thank you page, thank you your customer, telling them what they should be expecting, maybe check your email that, you know, you'll be receiving a confirmation email summarizing your purchase. It's your purchase receipt pretty much. Maybe give us feedback, maybe share this page, you know, like a link to share to Facebook or Instagram, or maybe take them to your YouTube channel or whatever it is, really, because you just kind of want to keep on selling your customer, you know. So let's say for me as an Amazon seller, typically what I would do for an upsell, I would offer them maybe two or three of the same product for a discounted price. So let's say if I'm selling them a $20 item, maybe I would give them an upsell of two more for $35. So I just knocked off $5. And if they don't buy that, maybe I will take them to a downsell page where I'm offering them either the main product for, let's say, 10% off or 20% off, or even a similar product that I also sell that's a little bit cheaper, you know, maybe like a $10 product or so that I'm still making a couple of dollars on. So that's kind of how sales pages work. Now, guys, this is the first video in my channel about sales funnels and specifically ClickFunnels and how it all works. I will be updating you guys. This is a new topic for me. I have been doing this for about 6 months now. I have, created success and actually expanded my business using sales funnels. So I definitely suggest you guys do so as well, but I will be posting more videos about ClickFunnels and sales funnels in general in the near future. Now, the question of the day, do you personally use sales funnels in your business? Go ahead and drop your question or your answer in the comments section below. Let me know if you guys do or not. And if you don't, let me know why you don't yet. And if you do, also let me know how it has benefited your business. Also, guys, in the comments section, Let me know if there's anything or any topic you guys want me to make in my channel or you guys want to see in my channel in the future. Aside from that, if you found this video interesting, be sure and consider subscribing. Also, give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much for tuning in. Have a great day.